Broadcasting live from the Vegas Video Network studios, just steps from the Las Vegas Strip, it's Talktails! And now our host, she's our very own kaleidoscope of talent.
What?
It's Kelly Clinton!
Welcome to Talktails, man, on the Vegas Video Network. I'm your host. My name is Kelly Clinton-Holmes, also known as Kelvis. I'm a little overexcited about our guest today. How about our live studio audience? Are you excited? Oh! If my voice wasn't out, I'd be screaming for the king. As you might guess, I'm having Anne Margaret on today. No, I'm not. That's another time. But I'm having our guest today is, wow, he's got to be my favorite Elvis here or anywhere in the world. You know, when you're a big Elvis fan, it's important that when you go to a show, you have to be open-minded, but we're kind of choosy and picky when we're a big Elvis fan. Well, this person really captures the Elvis, the essence of Elvis the King. He's starring at the LVH. I always want to say the other name that it used to be, but it's new branding and it's very cool. LVH in the Shimmer Showroom, Wednesdays through Mondays, dark on Tuesdays. Guess who our guest is? Mr. Trent Carlini is here today. Yeah, he is so good. He pretended to charge the stage because that has happened several times, but I told him, no. But anyway, I'm so excited because just saw the show the other night. But before we talk more about Trent and before we meet him, I want you to meet a few other people that are part of our family here at Talktails. We have an orchestra. I know that Trent is so excited about this because he's like, I didn't know there was an orchestra in my hand. Anyway, this orchestra is huge. Well, it's huge. It's so many. It's one person. It's Kenny Davidson, bow tie, daddy. Yeah, baby. Get your Elvis on, man. You know what? Keep playing, man. Are you an Elvis fan?
Absolutely.
Yeah, now they call you bow tie daddy, but you got room to be the king as well.
I can be the king of bow tie daddy.
The king of bow ties, yes. Don't let him fool you guys. He's nothing but trouble. You know trouble in the key of D?
No.
Doom, 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 doom. Now, I'll get back to you on that. It's boom, 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 boom. If you're looking for trouble, you came to the right place, Kenny. If you're looking for trouble, look right in my face, man. I was born standing up and talking back. My daddy wasn't green, I'm bad. Jack, I said on people. There you go. My middle name is Misery. Oh, it's so hard to do this sitting down, baby. I said I'm evil, so don't you mess around with me. Rock and roll, man. Take it home, Jim. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. I've just got to get this out of my system before Trent gets up here, because I'll be like, oh, do you know? And remember the song? And we come. Now I have to say hello to the producer, the creator of the Vegas Video Network, also a major Elvis fan and a major Trent Carlini fan now. Hello, Scott Whitney. Rock and roll, man. Rock and roll, baby.
That's all I got, baby.
You were at the show the same night I was at the show.
I was. It was a lot of fun.
You loved it, huh?
I did, because I won a dance contest.
Well, that's what I was going to say was, Trent does this contest for the greatest wiggle or the best kind of getting your thing, you know, holla on.
Yeah.
And I, for some reason, I already knew this was going to happen. But the spotlight goes, and it's traveling around the room, and boom, it lands on Scott Whitney, who is adding moves to Elvis that Elvis never had.
It's a gift, really.
Can you recreate a little bit?
Nope.
All right.
Can't do it.
And what did you win? What did you win? You won.
I won a CD.
You won a Trent Carlini CD?
I did, yes.
That's so great. Can I have it?
Yeah, no.
Oh.
All right, enough. You know, I think that you get enough. First of all, you don't need it, considering the outfit you're wearing. You look beautiful. You look awesome.
You know, I don't understand why everyone doesn't have an Elvis suit in their closet, right? I mean, I really think everyone should.
Because they look tight.
Well, listen, I don't really want to talk about that. I was going to ask Trent this, but I'm going to wait till he gets out here. Because, you know, I haven't worn this suit in a few months. And there's nothing between me and this suit because nothing would fit, if you know what I'm saying. Know what I'm talking about? Know what I'm saying?
Too much. Clint here?
No, but he's watching.
Oh.
He is watching, and I got to tell you this, and it's probably not a good career move for Clint if I tell you this, but come here, come closer. Everyone, one time, Clint tried to put my Elvis suit on, and it was frightening because it only went up to his holla, honka, amba. But anyway, don't tell anyone else. But you just showed a picture. I guess this is going to be all about Elvis, man, because you just showed a picture of me with the Elvis choir. This is how serious I am about the king, man. And I think Trent was even a part of it one time when I was just like, you know, sometimes you're with so many Elvises, you can't tell them apart. Is that racist? Is that racist?
I'm not sure.
But anyway, so that's a picture of some of the members of the Elvis choir. And that's, do you have the other one? That's when they make me wear the wig. So I'm hoping that, I think Trent knows some of these guys, and we'll talk about that because there's a community of Elvises, and I always wonder if they get along or if there's like, hey, you know, I'm sorry, I pulled your wig off and stuff like that. I don't know, but I know they're what they all have in common is the love of the king. Scott?
Yes?
What's your favorite part of the show the other night?
Except
for the wig.
Oh, I'm Trent.
Oh, you went to a lot of
shows. Our show.
Like, Trent's show. And tell the truth. Don't hold back. Bam! Favorite part. Right now. Quick.
The part where he was doing the tribute to the Hawaii part, the Hawaii thing.
The aloha from Hawaii.
I love that.
Yes, that was one of my favorite parts too. I love so many. But how about the?
Oh, I also like the. Oh.
How about the beautiful lady in the show?
She's right behind me, and she's got a gun.
I know. No. No, but oh my goodness, we're going to talk more about Ashley Bell too. She actually made me think about going to the gym yesterday. She is perfect. She's awesome. She's gorgeous and a very big part of the show, and we'll hear more about that. Scott, do
yes.
you know, can I tell you one more thing before I go to break, and I have one more little song I want to do quickly.
Sure.
But Clint Holmes was away this weekend, and he was in Buffalo, New York, and he was a part of a telethon that he has been a part of since he's probably a teenager. And the Shintas were there, and Eileen Graff, and Ben Lanzarone, and lots of other, Terry Buchwald, I don't know, he's an Elvis tribute artist. But anyway, they raised over $1.3 million.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yeah, so it's for the Children's Hospital, Women's and Children's Hospital, and it's called the Variety Kids Telethon every year. So let's give them a big round of applause. They worked so hard, and they made lots of money. I forgot to say that Kenny Davidson is at Don't Tell Mamas and also headlining over at the Tuscany. Who is your guest this week?
It's going to be Joey Pirro.
Trumpet player.
Oh, so you got, I love the trumpet too. I don't know if you know that.
Oh,
so
God.
Some of my fans in the audience.
Please.
And the show is this Friday
this
night
Friday,
at,
10
starting
o'clock.
At 10 o'clock. O'clock. And great. Joey
Pirro.
Pirro. Mm-hmm. Is that how you say it?
That's his name.
I've heard him. He's great.
And because
he sings as well.
He sings too.
So that's going to be a great show.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Scott, you haven't said a lot, but I have a feeling you'll be saying a lot more later. So I'm so excited about Trent Carlini coming up after the break, and I want to give him a little bit of my, I have a character I created when I was probably 8 years old. And well, she is, man. She's what would have happened if Ann Margaret and Elvis would have had a love child, man. And her name was Kelvis. Give me a little CC Rider. That's right, baby. If I could move, man, I would, baby, but I can't. I said, see, what you have done. I said, see, oh, see, right. See, what you have done. Well, you made me love you, and I'm not going to want me back at all. Now tell me what I say. Bring it down, I said, see. See, you see, around, bring it down, James. I said, see you soon. We're going to be right back, right after this, with more Talktails and my special guest. Trent Carlini. Woo! Sister Ride. I'm so sweet.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, I need to come up with something funny to say. 3, 2, 1. Wow. But the co-host. Really, I have to say watch it. Well,
that's how you do it. You don't
really?
Watch it. There
okay.
you go.
I got it. We are
the Odds Couple.
Hi, my name is Scott Pritchard.
And I am Anthony Padilla.
You're watching the Vegas Video Network.
You are.
You are. We are, too.
Oh, I'm so excited. This is one of my favorite entertainers here in Las Vegas, and you might have seen him on The Next Best Thing. He was the winner. He's starring at LVH in the Shimmer Showroom Wednesday through Monday in a show called The King, starring Trent Carlini. This is Trent Carlini. Hi! Yay! Woo! I am so excited and intrigued to have you. I enjoyed your show so much. How does it feel to be keeping the memory of Elvis alive after all these years and making so many Elvis fans happy reliving the music of the King?
It's just the most beautiful feeling in the world. It's incredible because you have so many people that come every night and they just enjoy themselves so much. You can just see the love they have for Elvis.
Yeah, it's like, because when you're an Elvis fan, as you could see as I was just spazzing out on the King, I mean, am I okay? Is there a promise? And if ever you feel a little hoarse one night or something, I could take your place, right, Ashley? Not in every way. But anyway, it's true. That's what I saw throughout the audience as well, is that all of us loved him so much that when it's done right, like you, because it's coming from love, isn't it?
It's passion. It's love. It's something that's been with me since I was just a little kid.
How old were you? Do you remember when you first...
I can't even remember the first time I heard Elvis. It's had to be at least 5 years old.
5 years old.
Yeah.
And you've been doing this kind of thing for how many years? Paying tribute to the King.
Here in Las Vegas since 1990.
Uh-huh.
I started out with Legends in concert. And prior to that, I was a singer in Europe with a rockabilly band, and we used to do Europop music and all that kind of stuff.
Uh-huh.
When I first started out as a kid, but I had the tendency to be pulled towards the Elvis realm because I wanted to be on stage and feel what it felt like to be like him and work with all the people that worked with him, and mm-hmm. you know, it was just magic.
Now, you actually had the opportunity to work with some of the people that Elvis worked with.
Yeah, I was very lucky to have met most of the greater of the goods that worked with Elvis, including Colonel Tom Parker.
Oh, and as you all know, that's the man who really helped Elvis.
It's a funny story. I met him, but he was in a deli on Flamingo.
Really?
And I was so terrified. Because he was really grumpy. He was barking at everybody. And so I just, you know, nonchalantly said hi, but I didn't say anything else.
Well, you didn't
what
say...
do you want?
You didn't say...
no.
Well, you figure he's been... did he live in town?
I believe so. At the time, he did live here or close by.
It sounds like a joke when you say, so I see Colonel Parker in a deli. This horse walks into a bar. But anyway, I'm weird. But yeah, I actually got to meet him as well. But did you,
I had an elephant for him. He collected elephants. And then one morning with Jerry Schilling, we had breakfast with his widow. And I offered to give it to him. And she said, are you kidding me? I just got finished cleaning out the house with all those elephants.
What was his fascination with elephants?
Well, because he was... I guess
he was a carny.
He was a carny guy.
Carny,
yeah, that's where he got the colonel from. And so, but he collected elephants of all sorts.
Well, elephants are supposed to be good luck, and I think you're supposed to win lots of money too.
Well,
I hope I'm right about that. So far, I guess I need to get an elephant.
But well,
anyway.
I guess it worked for him.
It sure did. I mean, he was a genius. Until Elvis met the colonel. Nobody knew who he was yet, right?
Yeah.
He was still struggling.
That's the story.
But he saw the specialness in him, right?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Boy, he was, now, Elvis was born in Tupelo,
Mississippi.
Mississippi. You got something great going on with that, huh?
Yeah.
Tell me.
I love Tupelo. I performed one of their first Elvis festivals, which was emceed by George Klein. Joe Esposito was there, Al DeVorn was there, and the mayor gave me the key to the city.
Wow.
Of Tupelo.
You know, I always wonder, first of all, that's a huge honor, right?
It's an incredible honor. It's been an incredible honor to have had people like Al DeVorin, the guy who invented the phrase Elvis has left the building.
You know? Oh, see? I didn't know that.
He was with Elvis since the very beginning. He was, you know...
Back in the Sun Records?
Before Sun, before yeah. Al DeVorin was just a great guy. He... I'll tell you about him, but I was honored by the mayor and his family with the key to the city, and we had a sold out 7,000 seat auditorium.
What?
Yeah.
Wow. And you did a concert?
Yes.
With a big orchestra? Or
yes, our big orchestra. We had dancers at the time in the show, which was a dance school from Chicago. I don't think they were really professional dancers, but it was just, you know, something that I used to do for local talents and mm-hmm. stuff like that to be able to perform and, you know, get their act on the road. And it was incredible. My show is the trademark was the Dream King.
Right.
And the name came about because I've always dreamed of becoming like the king.
Right.
Or performing his music. And when I worked with Legends, I just didn't feel like I had enough of just playing the mold that they wanted
exactly.
in their show. So I wanted to do all of Elvis's eras. And so that became my trademark, and many others to come copied that template to do different eras and
right.
stuff like that.
Well, that's because that's what happened is Elvis almost started to become a caricature of himself, and when I was going through some video clips today, I watched a bunch of you, and then I also watched a bunch of the King, and that same thing is still powerful right now. You get so moved, and you forget all about that caricature that has developed in our town, you know,
man.
With so many Elvises, but you capture the real essence
Thank
of the
you.
King, and it's a lot to do with what you just said. You kind of go through the years.
Thank you very much.
I
just find it very, I'm very proud of myself for taking all the experience that I've gathered in my life and career to putting to work techniques that Elvis used at certain times of his life, which is, it's not easy and it's not detectable. It's noticeable, but not detectable. So when you're watching my show, you'll see me singing in certain eras with a completely different technique than what I would sing in two eras later. You know, so
well,
it's...
Well, absolutely. I noticed a lot of those things, not that you're doing them, but I would get kind of shook up, well, if you know what I'm saying.
No.
But I mean, I was sitting with my friend, sitting with Jerry Jones, my friend, and I must have hit him or hit his leg or elbowed him 100 times. I go, whoa, did you see that? I go, that was so. I go, look at him right now, Just little things you did, man, little things that you're, just so the king. And you're right, through the different eras,
it's
different.
It's you embody it. It's something that I probably couldn't do if when I wake up in the morning and say, do this. It wouldn't even work unless I go through my spiritual gathering when I, you know, get ready for the show, go through hair and makeup, and I do something mentally where I just really zone there. And when I cross the curtain, it's just like crossing through time.
Oh, that's such a great way to put it. Because you're an actor.
Yeah.
You're an actor.
When I walk through that curtain, it's like something happens.
Right.
You know, and it's just really beautiful
thing. It's like
it
comes with you.
Yeah, I'm getting a little emotional, man. You got a little hanky.
All right, yeah, I do. I got some tissue. I love that. I feel like Barbara Walters. I can make him cry, maybe. Okay, now I see that we have a live chat question. Scott, who do we have?
We do. We've got a couple. The first one's from DT Benefits. He wants to know, who makes your outfits?
That's top secret.
I was going to say, that's a little personal, man.
There's a few companies out that make these outfits. I'm not going to say any names. But if you look carefully on the internet, there's a lot of people that make these outfits. There's a lot of people that make these outfits, and they're cost effective, you know, where some of these outfits cost like $5,000.
Right.
Like I, you know, a cape alone cost, when I bought it, was $3,000. And I can't even wear the cape because I fall on the floor with it.
It's just so heavy. This is too heavy. All right, so you're saying you got to be careful, man. You got to
go on the internet, type Elvis jumpsuits, and look at everybody out there, and you'll find, you know, you'll find a pair of pajamas that'll fit you.
Yeah, you know, I have two Elvis suits, and one of them is like a Halloween costume, and then there's this one, man. But it is true.
That's beautiful.
Thank you, man. Oh, man. Yeah, this is cool. This is made by a guy who does. Anyway, back to you. Do we have another live question, Walt?
Yes, somebody named Husband.
Wait, that sounds like you're not married to a man, are you?
Yeah.
So it must be.
Might be your husband.
It might be mine.
Or mine. He wants to know, was Elvis actually leaving the building when that phrase was coined?
Was Elvis actually leaving the building?
The Colonel, because every time Elvis finished performing, the stage got rushed all the time. And the Colonel told Al DeVorin to go up on stage and say something to the audience so that they wouldn't rush the stage. When God bless Al DeVorin, he went up there, he said, "Ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has left the building. Thank you and good night."
Wow.
That was it.
And boy, man, I mean, and people say that to this day.
Yeah.
Whether Elvis is in the building or not, whether Trent's there or not, they just go, "Elvis has left the building, man." Yeah. So it's probably the most coined phrase in the entire world.
Yeah, my favorite guy who said it was Will Smith in the movie, what was that space movie back in the 90s? Impact? Yeah.
What's it called?
No. Independence Day. When they're leaving.
Independence Day.
With Jeff Goldblum, and they're leaving in the spaceship. He's like, "Elvis has left the building."
Yeah, baby.
That's right. Makes me proud every time I hear it. Oh, man, they're thinking about me. Oh.
That was good. Really quick, back to the jumpsuits, because I haven't worn mine in a very long time, and I kind of talk about rituals and spiritual.
Right.
I was like, "Please, Lord, let me be able to zip this jumpsuit up just today, please." I mean, because, you know, we all, our weight fluctuates. You know, maybe that doesn't happen to you. I don't know. But have you ever, do you have, like, maybe one for the larger Trent or the smaller Trent?
Well, it's not the weight that I'm concerned about when I put it on. It's just other parts that need to be, you know, relaxed.
Yeah, right? Because what happens is it ends up between here and here being shorter somehow. And then you can sing higher than you ever did when it's at your... Anyway, I'm just sharing too much, I'm sure.
And when you're in a hurry and you're zipping it up really fast, you got to be... very careful.
Quick change could be really big change.
Yes, it could be a big change.
You could be chastity and then Chaz.
Right?
Wait a minute. Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have. That wasn't very nice. Anyway, it was the opposite. Anyway, Chaz. I didn't. But anyway, I just enjoyed the show so much. And you're not alone in the show.
I'm not.
There was this gorgeous lady.
I have a co-star. Yes.
Yes. And tell us about
Ashley
Bell.
You know, when the show started originally, I had many dancers. And there was just one dancer that I saw, and I just fell in love with how she danced and moved through the air.
Yeah.
Like she has this energy when she Absolutely. Flows through the air, and the way she dances and moves. And it's like she tells a story through movement. And I had never seen that before. I've just, you know, seen regular choreography, regular, you know, just Vegas dancers, you know, da 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 da
right.
da da da. And sorry, I had to stretch my leg, man.
Man, be careful, man. We
so
don't want anything to go wrong.
I was putting together a tribute for Anne Margaret and Elvis to tell the untold love story, or if there was or not, or just the relationship value of the moment. And it was to a song, a particular song that's changed now. It's Home, that I re-recorded from Foster. Mm-hmm. and I saw her rehearsing it, and this was a very long number. I think at the time it was like over 4 minutes.
Yeah.
And that is very unusual for a dancer to do a solo.
And to really hold the attention,
yes,
right?
Yes, and when I saw her rehearsing, I had to go up to her and gave her a big hug, and I said, thank you. I said, that was very beautiful. I loved it.
Yeah,
so
she's
from
special.
That point on, we, as a team, grew a beautiful working relationship where we exchanged ideas, and she started coming in more and more numbers, and basically turning into a co-star
right.
for every era and every moment, and relieving me from having to be on stage so I can change into a different outfit, doing a
and
number.
And no rushing in the zipper.
Right, you know. I mean, I saved at least 200 Band-Aids this year.
It's so modest.
I'm really grateful for that. However, Ashley Bell.
Yes, very special.
She's danced her whole life, and well, we can have her tell you.
Yeah, we're gonna bring her up at the end of the show.
She's just an amazing performer, not just dancer.
She really is, and friendly. And I had the pleasure of working at the Hilton the LVH for a little while in another show where I was a nun, and but that's another story. But we shared a dressing room for a little while, and she was very friendly. Didn't know her at all at the time, and just was very sweet and friendly. And I was so impressed with her in the show. I really was.
Yeah, she's really incredible.
She really is. Do we have another live chat question, Scott?
We do. Mesmer wants to know, he said, I've seen old clips of Elvis and was astonished to see him just walk around and kiss women in the audience. Does Trent attempt to do the same thing?
Ooh, that's a good question, because he really did. He smacked them right on the lips, baby. They were full-on kisses.
I did for many years, back in the 90s, or... you know, I used to try to do whatever Elvis did, and it worked. That's why I got into Elvis in the first place, you know.
Right. Well, I'll...
But something terrifying happened one
Uh-oh.
Day. A girl grabbed me by the head and bit my lip, and I couldn't get her off of my face.
What?
So I had
So I
tapped her on the face. She let go and then came back and bit me again.
Oh my goodness!
On the cheek.
This is serious.
Yeah, and I was bleeding all over the place, and it was just got awful. And from that day on, they can kiss my sideburns.
Yeah, that's frightening.
I'm terrified.
She was here on the cannibal convention.
Yeah.
No, but that's serious. I know what you mean, because I've had some weird things happen too, and it is frightening. And you went on with the show.
The show was over.
Yeah, the show was.
I had
Elvis is bleeding out the building. Right? That
Elvis
is horrible.
Elvis has bled the building. I had to get stitches
that is
and everything.
Horrible.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you brought that up, Scott.
Yeah. Thanks for bringing up old memories. I appreciate it.
Well, I wanted to ask you, do you relate to any of the eras more than the others? I mean, there was the 68 comeback special with the leather suit and the whole thing, and then the Aloha from Hawaii, which was like the first satellite show all over the world, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I remember that.
Blue Hawaii.
Fun
in Acapulco. I mean, the eras I do are seven or eight of the most popular ones. But there's just so much more that I love and relate to. And I've related as I've gone on in life. Like songs like, Maybe I Didn't Treat You Quite As Good As I Should Have. Like, I never understood that song until I lived through a moment like that. So a lot of songs that Elvis did, I related to as I went on in life.
Separate ways, right?
Yeah.
Separate.
I see a change is coming to my life. It's not the same as it used to be, you know?
So great.
So beautiful.
There's so many songs, you can't possibly do them all.
I would have a different show for a year every night.
Yeah, that's too much. So are we gonna bring on Ashley for a minute? Oh, we're going to take a break, and we're going to come right back, because we need more Trent Carlini, and we're going to meet that beautiful lady we were talking about earlier on Talktails after this.
This is David Ivey for Pub Crawl. It's funny, because this is David from... Wait. You should just leave it on. Hi, I'm David Ivey from Pub Crawl, and you're watching the Vegas Video Network. And scene.
Traditional media believes that after about 3 minutes, you'll tune out. Most Vegas media companies think if it doesn't jiggle, you won't tune in. At the Vegas Video Network, we think both are wrong. The Vegas Video Network is the first and only live online broadcast network that specializes in insider news and expert views about Vegas. We combine great storytelling with the ability to watch when and where you want, on your computer, mobile device, or television. Discover the real Las Vegas. Visit VegasVideoNetwork.com.
Ah, welcome back to Talktails. I'm your host, Kelvis Clinton Holmes, and I'm joined by my guest, Trent Carlini, and now joined by his very own Anne Margaret, a beautiful lady named Ashley Bell, who's a part of the show at the LVH. Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
God, you were so great the other night that, you know, I have to tell you that my friend Jerry Jones was like, I don't know if she's involved, man, but whoever it is, she needs to leave him for me. And I said, that can happen. And he said, what, Jerry?
In a parallel universe.
Yes, in a parallel universe, because you're like dream girl. And is it a secret that you're not just co-workers and collaborators? Is it, can we share with them?
Trent works for me.
I love it.
I love her. We're married.
They're married.
We got married in April.
Oh, that's so great.
So, yeah.
What a beautiful thing. And you work together. Is that, so which came first? No, that's not a good question. Did you fall in love as you were working together?
I fell in love the minute I saw her.
Ooh, you're good, you. And well, we don't talk about a time frame, but how long were you together before you said, I just can't be without her? This is the tough questions, Trent.
The minute that we connected as partners in the relationship, I'm very like
quick with your decisions.
You know when you know.
When I make a decision, it's
right.
Yeah. I look the word decision up, and it means. Right. So once it's done, it's done. So I made a decision to marry her before she got away.
Oh, I love it! I love it.
To a parallel universe or something like that.
So Ashley, what is it like working with your life partner as well as your business partner?
It's great, but you know Trent and I, like he said, when he goes through the curtain. It really is everything aside, the work relationship aside, the personal relationship aside, and we both truly love what we do so much, and we're just in performance mode. We're in storytelling and like you said, acting and the passion behind the music and the art, and then the show's over and then we hold hands. But during that moment, we're really just embodied in the acting and the storytelling of the tribute of Elvis's life and all the eras and the movie years.
And that's what I got too, was there was a definite arc to the show, you know, and emotionally as well as going through the time of all the different times of Elvis's life, the movies, the Anne Margaret stage, which I thought was a really, really terrific idea, mm-hmm. was they kind of created the illusion of what if or
it's,
what
it's like painful. two great performances on stage at the same time.
Yes.
Like I never shared the stage with anybody in my life. I've always performed solo, and for her to be on stage with me means I think very highly of her, and so does everyone else that sees her perform. She's just, you know, incredible at what she does.
And were you a big Elvis fan as well? Because
I've learned
you're
a lot.
Young lady.
Yeah, I've learned a lot about Elvis, and I've learned. A lot about the movies. They weren't necessarily things I was familiar with. Everybody knows Elvis, and everybody knows his music. I don't think I was able to grasp how huge his music was, how
Absolutely.
Almost every song you hear, Elvis sang it to. Or
Absolutely.
Or you just hear rhythms or melodies in songs, and it all stems from Elvis music.
And it's amazing how powerful he is to this day. And that's why when you're like Trent Carlini, really, really with through love, paying tribute to your
By the year 2025,
artist.
Everybody will have a jumpsuit. I promise you. And I'll be president.
You'll be president. Well, I want to thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you, Kelly.
Would you
want me to sing a song for you?
Sing a song, baby.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Sing it. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
Ooh, so beautiful. Oh, thank you so much, Trent. Thank you,
thank
Ashley.
You.
Now, Wednesday through
Monday.
Through Monday at the LVH, the show time
6:30.
Is 6:30. You don't want to miss this. Do you have a little return to sender in there? Just take it out with a little bit of that. I want to thank you so much. We enjoyed your show tremendously.
Thank you.
And I'll be back, man. I'll be back to see you. Oh, and it's blue. Thank you.
Return to sender. Return the sender.
There we go. Perfect.
I gave a letter to the postman. He put it in his sack.
Bottom, bottom, bottom.
Bright and early next morning, I came right back to. She wrote a funny. Return the sender. Address unknown. No such person. No such zone.
We had a quarrel.
Go ahead, hit it more.
Oh, love is spat.
I write, I'm sorry, but my letter keeps coming back. So when I dropped it in a mailbox, I seen a special D. Right and early next morning, I came right back to. She wrote upon it.